Hello, welcome back. I hope everybody has been having an amazing week so far. I am super excited because this is a brand new tarot book released by Chris Ann, and it is a book to go with her Light Seers tarot, which I do have the mini tarot in a tin of the Light Seers, and it was the first a tarot deck that I really connected with, which I was a little surprised by that because the imagery on the deck is very much beach related and I don't really have a connection to the beach. I did get to go once when I was 9 and, you know, I have always wanted to go back to the ocean, but I don't have this strong connection or anything, you know, so I didn't think that I would, you know, bond with the deck as much as I did, but I did. And recently, Chris Ann, literally a couple weeks ago, Chris Ann published, this book was released, and I really wanted it, but it was farther down on my list of priorities at this time. And then I saw that Hay House had this brand new book on sale 60% off. So instead of $24.99, this book was $10. I was like, I cannot resist it now. So I got it and it arrived today. I'm super excited. It says, A Journey Through the Symbols, Messages and Secrets of the Cards. So it's a more in-depth book into the tarot for the Light Seers. And it's beautiful. Of course, you know I love this color. This is one of my favorite colors. Tarot for Light Seers. Right now, Light Seers are needed more than ever. Step into a realm of symbolism, magic, healing, and meaning as you travel the shadows and sunshine-laden path of the Light Seer. Whether you're a seasoned card slinger or just beginning your journey, this expanded guide will help you tune in to the quietest whispers of your intuition and connect with the deeper meanings of the cards as you dive into the artwork and messages of the Light Seers Tarot. Filled with loving messages from the tarot archetypes, Tarot for Light Seers invites you to uncover your infinite potential while also taking sacred accountability through introspective journaling prompts, unique spreads to connect to the major arcana, new correspondences for healing, as well as a side-by-side comparison to the classic Rider-Waite-Smith tarot. This richly detailed guidebook is an ode to your inner journey, a call to step into the intuitive and healing world of the Light Seer. Are you ready to see, believe, and become the light that guides the way forward? And it is published by Hay House. On the inside cover it says, And into the gray we follow, like a thousand flickering stars, and there in a sunlit hollow, we lose and find what is ours. Ooh, I love the feel of these pages. So let's see our table of contents. I was looking through the camera and I thought that was a little bee there, but it's not. Dearest Light Seer, tarot as a tool for healing, tarot basics for the card slinger, the major arcana, the minor arcana, a note on upright cards and reversals, connecting with your cards, readings and spreads. And then we go into the major arcana and the minor arcana, and then tarot correspondences. So we have a Light Seers and Rider-Waite-Smith symbols chart, major arcana correspondences, which has astrology, element, runes, music, body and healing, runes, cheat sheet, elements and elementals, and tarot landscapes. And then we go into it. So let's just, and these signatures are sewn in and not glued in. That's nice. Let's just pick a random page and we'll read about that card. Two of Cups. So the Two of Cups here. Oops, sorry for shaking the camera. Let me make it still. So here is what this page looks like. And then this page. So she points out things from the cards. So let's see. We have a rainbow bracelet. Love is love. Prism water has all the colors of light, all the potential. Magic created by the emotion of love. Green and red bowls. The green is the heart chakra for love, and the red is the root chakra for safety. There's a wedding ring and new horizons. Sun equals joy. Oh, and then it does the, oh, that was for the Two of Cups. And then down here, it also shows the Ace of Cups. But we won't go over the Ace of Cups right now because we're just going to read about the Two of Cups. The Light Seer message is romantic partners, soulmates, friendships, connected hearts, passion, kindred spirits, joyful connection and cooperation, union, sometimes marriage, duality, love, consciousness. The Shadow Seer message is emotional blocks, not being open to receive love, disharmony, unions disrupted, separation, healing past trauma, and a need to rethink a relationship. A Cups story. Love at first sight? Possibly. Attraction at first millisecond? Definitely. Like matter and antimatter, day and night, yin and yang. Some things are primed to complement each other. Our whole universe shines with examples of charged opposites that are drawn into each other's gravitational pull. And sometimes when the moon is ripe and the stars align, these opposites find their match and they are able to sustain this beautiful alchemy without fizzling or draining each other. In such moments, like the moment when two souls unite, an outpouring of magic spills forth. Ideas flow and manifest in every color of the light spectrum. Conversations expand and vibrate at a frequency beyond the sum of the two parts. Work becomes purpose. Kindreds become soul family. There is nothing to do except to witness, embody, and delight in this intoxicating partnership. Message from the Two of Cups. When you share your joy with those around you, you will attract deep and meaningful ties with others. This card whispers of romance and love, bliss and attraction, and the unity of the like-hearted. Sometimes it signifies the beginning of a new friendship or a business partnership, while at other times it marks a profound romantic union. This perfect pairing of matched souls has the potential to develop into the magical and intoxicating entanglement of souls, mating, or the merging of paths that will be forever united or changed. If you are single, look for the arrival of a romantic companion who will be a profoundly passionate and devoted lover. In shadow, this card is a reminder that the love hormone, oxytocin, is emitted when we experience feelings of love or jealousy, and that we can be addicted to either feeling. Choose to consciously remain on the side that serves up doses of love. Sometimes this card suggests a breakup, a falling out, or a need to consciously work on a partnership. Are you putting enough energy into your relationships? How you see yourself as one half of a committed pair will deepen and shift as the effervescent magic of the Two of Cups bubbles into your life. It will serve as a sacred reflection for who you really are, shadow and light, with an intermingling of spirit, emotion, love, harmony, and balance. Remember that soul ties can illuminate
our deepest growth opportunities, and our most exquisite idiosyncrasies. And your flourishing involvement with another will grant you a gateway to your own highest evolution. I thrive in partnerships and I revel in this sacred magic of connection. Questions for the seer. Are you open to making new soul connections? And then people often say, when I find love, I will be happy. Or when I have money, or when I have that job, etc. Remember that when you are happy, you will attract all those things into your life. Are you waiting on external things to feel fulfilled and whole? How can you stop waiting and start living? Beautiful. And then just to show you in the major, for the major arcana, it, you know, has the same page showing symbols in the, explaining symbols in the card, the light seer message, shadow seer, an emperor story, because this is the emperor. The emperor's message. We'll have the affirmation and questions for the seer. But also, for every major arcana, there is a tarot spread to help you delve deeper. So, just to share that with you. Beautiful. Cannot wait to use this book with my Light Seers Tarot next year. Once we hit spring again. And then also, speaking of spring, while I was on Hay House's website to get that book, I saw a deck that's been on my list to get that is on sale 50% off, which is the Enchanted Forhaxa Tarot. And I wasn't going to bother getting this deck till closer to spring because I wanted to use this deck during the light half of the year. But since it was 50% off, I thought, might as well get it now. So let's check it out. This is by MJ Cullinan. And get lost in the land of the fairies to find your magic. From the creator of Crow Tarot, this 78-card tarot deck and guidebook invites you to step through a portal into the mystical world of Forhaxa, named for the Swedish word meaning to enchant. Inspired by Norse folk tales and fairy lore, the earthy, richly detailed illustrations bring the fairies, mermaids, heroes, and villains of this deck to life. The traditional tarot suits are replaced with fire, water, air, and earth, grounding the power of this deck not in man-made items, but in the foundational elements of nature. I love this dark teal color. So here is the inside of our box. A wild and magical realm hidden deep in the forest where shadows mingle with sunlight, fairies flutter, and mermaids swim. And then we have that beautiful image there with the purple iris, the red and the red tulips. And then I don't know that flower, but that just makes me think of my grandfather. His favorite flower was the purple iris, and he also had tulips. So, and then here is the backs of the cards, which actually I believe is supposed to be leaves, but it makes me, it's reminiscent of a peacock tail to me. So that's where my mind goes when I see these colors and those. There are leaves, but they also remind me of peacock feathers. So this is a gorgeous deck. It's matte, I believe. That's matte and nice cardstock. And let's dig into this beautiful deck. And we have a gorgeous Fool card here. This beautiful fairy. She has little horns. And she's sitting on a beehive covered with honey and bees. And we have a beautiful bird over here. And are these cherry blossoms? It's a gorgeous way to start off this deck. And the magician, she's beautiful too. I love her beautiful black wings. She also has horns. She's got a sword and a snake. We've got the crocus. Okay, so these might be cherry blossoms. We might have a different flower with each card, maybe. That's a crocus, I believe. And we have the pinnacle down here, and we have some eye symbols. Beautiful. The High Priestess. I love it. Her more dragon-like or bat-like wings. Gorgeous dress. Very reminiscent of Klimt with the spiral design in the collar and the square and triangle designs in the dress. We have the moon phases in the water. I love this deck so much. The Empress. Again, with Klimt patterns in the background. Purple iris. Her beautiful wings. And we have the hair, two hairs. These are orchids, I believe. The Council of Monarchs. Instead of the Emperor, we have the Council of Monarchs. And then you can see each one is representing a different element. Fire, water, earth, and air. We have the black feathers down here. And if you notice, all of them have horns. Beautiful. The Hierophant. So she's sitting down here by herself. She's got the black wings. These are the snowdrop flowers. We have this beautiful deer here with the sun coming through the woods, the trees. And then down below, their roots and the magma. Beautiful. The Lovers. This is a gorgeous card as well. And again, very Klimt, reminiscent of Klimt designs, only a little bit more abstract on the dresses. The Chariot. Ooh, I love this Chariot card. Gorgeous. Strength with the dragon. Again, I love this card. I think I love just about every card in this deck. I might accidentally continue to say that. And I believe this one is Ferns, maybe. Oh, the Hermit is beautiful. I'm sorry, I will try to go faster. This video is getting long. The Wheel of Fortune, Justice, The Hanged Man, Death. Sorry if you can hear mom's TV. At first I thought my mom was yelling at me to shut up, but it was her TV. Temperance, the Devil, the Tower, the star. The moon. The sun. Judgment. The world. And then we have Ace of Fire with the crows or ravens. Two of Fire. Three of Fire. Four of Fire. Five of Fire. Six of Fire. Seven of Fire. Eight of Fire. Nine of Fire. Ten of Fire. Page of Fire. Knight of Fire. Queen of Fire. And I love how the court cards have these borders on them. I think they're really pretty. Queen of Fire. And instead of kings, we have Elder of Fire. And we have the... oh my gosh, the name of the hammer just went out of my head, but y'all know what it is. And we have a bunch of different kind of eyes in her dress. Here is the Ace of Water, a gorgeous mermaid. Two of Water. Three of Water. Four of Water. Five. Aww. Six of Water. That's precious. Seven of Water. And this right here reminds me of June Mermaid. Eight of Water. Nine of Water. We definitely have a different representation of different sizes here. Ten of Water. Page. Knight. Queen and Elder of Water. Next is Ace of Air. Ooh, we got the dragons. Two of Air. Three of Air. Four, five, six, seven. And there's our Elder Council in the background. And then she's like camouflaged into the bush. Eight of Air. Ooh, this one creeps me a bit. This one creeps me a little bit. I am working on my spider thing, but these particular spiders are more on the creepy side for me. And the fact that they have her spun up in their web, in a cocoon of their web. Nine of Air. Ten. Page. Knight. Queen. Oh, look at her. The queen bee. And Elder of Air. Next is my favorite suit, the Earth suit or Pentacles. We have the Ace of Earth, two, three. There's our fox for Silver Soul Fox. Four. Five, six, seven, eight, nine. 10, page, knight, queen, and our Elder of Earth. Gorgeous deck. And now that I see it in person, I don't have to wait to spring to use this deck. This deck would be perfect to use right now as well. I love this deck. I could see this deck being used all year, whether it's the light half of the year, the dark half of the year. Stunning deck. Let's get a good shuffle going and pick a card to read. This is thicker cardstock, so it's a little tougher to riffle shuffle. But I'm sure as you use it and it gets more broke in. Let's get a message for the collective. We got the Queen of Air. Let's check out our book. We have an introduction, preparing to use your deck, card spreads, questions from the Major Arcana. Oh, that's interesting. The ground we walk on, the plants and creatures, the clouds above constantly dissolving into new formations. Each gift of nature possessing its own radiant energy together by cosmic harmony. Ruth Bernard. Quick like a fairy spread. Questions from the Major Arcana. Oh, that's cool. So for the Fool. Are you letting the fears or opinions of others prevent you from taking a leap of faith? And it is a black and white guidebook, which that's fine. So let's get to the Queen of Air. And that's about how much you get. That's Queen of Air. That's Elder of Air. The Queen Bee with the purple border that stuck out to me. Beautiful. While the Knight of Air is sharp and speaks directly without mincing words, the Queen of Air's maturity softens their message without losing information. They manage to find amusement even in times of difficulty or in an unpleasant challenge that would sting others. When the Queen of Air appears, remember, they are full of life experience, and because of this, if a situation has become messy or uncomfortable, they know just what to do. Approaching a problem with a clear understanding of what is going on will help you be upfront and honest with yourself and others. The Queen's advice: obstacles are easier to surmount when you address them sooner rather than later. Use this energy to help you quickly assess the action needed to glide over hurdles with grace and humor. During a reading, the Queen of Air may enter to lighten the mood without diminishing the circumstance's seriousness. Let her help you quickly size up a situation, as her influence will aid you to cut through any superfluous information that may be creating indecision. Well, this is a stunning deck, and I am so happy that they had it 50% off and I got it now, because I had in my mind not to use this deck until spring and summer, like I said, but I feel like this deck could totally be used now. It doesn't quite fan as easily as one might hope, but I don't tend to fan my cards really that much anyway, so no big deal to me. I was just trying to spread them out so you could see them. Well, I hope you all have an amazing day. If you're still here, thank you so much for watching my long video. Especially because I know this is not a new tarot deck, so many of you may have already seen this deck. But I am super excited to have this deck, plus my Tarot for Light Seers book from Chris Ann. Thank you all, and I hope you all have a magical night. Bye.